They agree they cook the books to boost stock prices, and today the government says they will pay for their crimes.
KNBC9's Beth Chapman live at the federal courthouse where an investigation into a local pasta company is revealed. Beth.
Maria, people in Kansas City have known for some time that the American-Italian pasta company was in trouble. Today, they learned why. The people making the pasta in Excelsior Springs knew the market was tough. The popularity of low-carb diets meant many people were cutting back. But the earnings for the Italian-American pasta company from 2002 to 2004 didn't reflect that.
These AIPC executives were obsessed with meeting quarterly and annual earnings guidance given to the investing public and engaged in multiple types of accounting fraud to meet those expectations.
Today, the government showed how the largest maker of dry pasta in North America did it, how it cooked the books to make it look like it was making money when it wasn't, and showed what happened to stock prices when in 2005, the company amended its earnings statements.
This announcement caused a sudden drop in the price of AIPC stock. That drop in price caused substantial harm to those investors who had purchased at the artificially inflated price.
In fact, court documents indicate the company had overstated its income by $59 million, a fictitious 66%. Today, the government announced the former CEO and CFO entered into plea agreements. The CEO will pay $1 million to settle the SEC complaint. The company will pay $7.5 million for the actions of its former officers.
These guilty pleas send a clear message that no one is above the law, no matter how high they may be in the corporate hierarchy.
Back live now, the U.S. Attorney's Office is quick to point out that the allegations in the plea agreement only involve former employees, and they do say they'll go after jail time in the case of the top two men. In addition to the criminal complaint, the SEC has filed a civil action against the company and its former officers. We are live at the federal courthouse. Back to you.
And Bev, we also know the company reached a $24 million settlement in a class action suit involving investors. A spokesman today said it has taken steps to make sure something like this never happens again.